Hello everyone and welcome to my new Dory Paint video. Today I'm going to continue working on my Zodiac doll collection, and since now in the end of July we are stepping into a Leo season, it means it's time to make a Leo doll. Honestly, the concept of this doll was clear for me from the very beginning. I could really see it in front of my eyes. And now also in a couple of days, for me it probably in a week or in 10 days, for you it's already probably happened now, the Lion King movie is coming out, and all these trailers are so gorgeous, so amazing, so breathtaking really, that they made me just even more motivated to make a very strong, very powerful, but at the same time absolutely gorgeous, the Lion Queen. Or like in my head as a concept, I see it as really like an African tribe leader, a tribe queen, or yeah, the Lion Queen. There will be some lion connection in this doll. And it feels even quite annoying and frustrating that there is still so much work to do to turn this Claudine doll into this image that I have in my head. But anyway, let's start working, and I'm going to begin like always with removing the outfit. As a model, I'm going to use this Claudine doll. I think she has an absolutely amazing potential to become an ideal Lion Queen. So first of all, I'm going to remove her outfit, and then I'm going to cut her hair as short as I can. And while I'm busy, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you are new here. I upload new Dory Paint videos every week Friday, so welcome to the family. And I will start working. Then I make the doll's head soft with a hair dryer to make the rubber soft and to melt the glue inside of the head. And then I can disconnect the head from the body, and after this I can remove the rest of this short hair together with some old nasty sticky glue that we will for sure see inside. Yep, you can see it now. There is a lot of this nasty glue inside this time, and it's really sticky. Now let's take pure acetone, some cotton pads and Q-tips, and remove her original makeup. I'm going to give her new hair in this beautiful amaretto color. It will be a little bit lighter than her skin tone in the end, and I think it will look very complimentary. So now I'm taking my rerouting tool, and I'm going to refill all these holes in her head with tiny strands of hair. Here is her new hair a couple of hours later. Now I will add tacky glue to the inside of the head to keep all this new hair inside, and I will let the glue dry for at least 24 hours. To be able to draw on the doll's face, I've sealed it with 3 layers of Mr. Super Clear primer like always, and now I can start creating the new face. And I begin like usually with sketching her eyes and eyebrows, then I'm going to draw the nostrils and the lips. After this, I blush her face with soft pastels, and this step requires a couple of layers to build up. And between the layers, I protect my work and set all the powders with Mr. Super Clear again. I draw the eyelids more detailed with a pencil, and then I add a touch of blush to the cheeks. I've protected the previous layers with this sealant again, and now I can add more color to her face, starting with the white of her eyes. I want to give her very light gray eyes, because I think it will look stunning and absolutely magical in combination with her dark skin and with the accessories I'm going to make later today. And then I add more shadows and highlights. With a very sharp black pencil, I draw the bottom eyelashes and also add some tiny details. And then I can add reflections to her eyes using white acrylics. For my very special African girl today, I want to create a variation of a traditional African makeup. They mostly use white paint for it, but I'm going to use gold acrylics today to make her really glow and shine and be absolutely gorgeous, because she's a queen, you know? I also blush her body with soft pastels, and after this I'm going to add some golden ornaments to her skin as well. Well, and now let's talk about her hair. Of course, today I'm going for some main looking hair. We're going to make it big, we're going to make it really massive, messy. And to reach this effect, the main hair effect, I'm going to use probably the same technique I use for my Merida doll to make these Merida curls. I'm going to use this barbecue stick. Wrap hair around barbecue stick really strand per strand, and then I'm going to warm it up with this flat iron. And look how gorgeous it is in the end. I just want to cut all these messy ends and the hair is done. Looks so pretty. And now it's finally time for her outfit and for the accessories, because I have some really cool ideas today. So for the outfit, my mom was responsible today, and let's take a look at what she has made. I've asked my mom to make a leather costume for my doll, and I think it looks very, very cool. It's a very thin leather used normally for making gloves, and this pattern on the front is painted on with acrylics. And she has also made a necklace and a pair of stunning bracelets for my doll. So, let's put the outfit on the doll, the jewelries I will put on in the end. And now it's time to make a whole bunch of accessories to complete the look, because of course, this is just the beginning. And as a tiny addition to this outfit, I have already prepared this piece of fur to put it around her waist. And before I start working on other things, I'm going to make a bunch of tiny skulls out of epoxy skull, because it will take them for sure 24 hours to dry. And meanwhile, I can put this leather stripe around her head, and to the middle of the forehead I'm going to attach a dark green feather and a golden rhinestone. Now let's make a belt bag for her using Warbla. Warbla is a thermoplastic, it gets very soft when you warm it up with hot air, and it gets hard again after it cools down. And this is just ideal for making cosplay outfits and also for doll accessories. Thank you. And here I will finally knit our pre-made skulls because I'm going to hang them on the belt next to the back. I covered the back and the belt with brown acrylics first, then I dry brush it with black acrylics to give it some extra texture, and after this I decorate it with golden dots. Then I want to make a pair of sandals that would match this necklace piece with some round details and with rhinestones, so I'm starting with making a pair of basic sandals out of warbler. Then I take this old and rusty instrument for making holes in paper and I cut out 6 tiny warbler circles. And these tiny round pieces I'm going to attach to the sandals. Now let's cover it all with acrylics and then I add rhinestones to the middle of these round plates. And I think we've completed this mission successfully, because the shoes and the necklace, they look for sure like a part of the same set. I was doubting for a really long time if I wanted to give an African spear to my doll, because I don't really want to give her this aggressive vibe. I don't want to put anything, you know, like violence related there to my dolls. Yes, I know she wears a bunch of skulls on her waist, but you know, who knows where these skulls are coming from and from who these skulls are coming from. Maybe all these people, I don't know, maybe they died from some natural reasons. It's also possible. Or who knows, maybe she made these skulls out of epoxy sculpt to scare the people around her. So I've decided to not go with the spear, but I'm going to make some sort of an African staff that, like, these people are going to see that she's a real tribal leader here. So, and I'm going to start with this barbecue stick. And I'm going to cover this barbecue stick completely with epoxy sculpt to create a pretty texture. Then I sculpt some sort of an African mask and I attach it to the stick. I let this epoxy dry for 24 hours and then I cover it with acrylics. In the end, I still want to add a bunch of feathers to the top of the mask, and I think it's finished. And it looks really cool, guys, I think. I still need to attach the false lashes and to add glossy varnish to the doll's eyes and lips. And then we're going to put it all together and take a look at the end result pictures. But wait, guys, I think our Lion Queen also requires some lions to complete the picture. So here they are, these lions I haven't made myself, sorry guys, I bought them online, but I think they've made an ideal company for my doll. So now it's for sure time for the end result pictures. You know, guys, I really think this is probably the coolest doll I've ever made in my entire career. We're even laughing with my husband that it was probably just the coolest doll even posted on the internet, because he also adores her completely. So, I really hope you like her as well. And I especially hope my Leo people here like the end result of this transformation today, because this doll is completely dedicated to you. And by the way, my father is a Leo too, and there's even more. It's his birthday today on Friday when this video goes online, so please don't hesitate to write your birthday wishes to my father and to all our Leos here in the comments down below. And this doll is available on eBay now for sale, so if you feel like adopting an African tribe queen with a bunch of skulls on her waist and with a lion, so the link will be in the description box under this video. So I want to wish one more time the very happy birthday to all my Leo people here. I really hope you enjoyed this transformation today. And that was it for today. Please don't forget to support my art here on YouTube with your likes. Of course, subscribe to my channel, hit the bell button, and we will see each other already very soon, next week Friday, in my new doll repaint video. Love you guys. Bye.